693. Text 85058. Text will be charged at your standard message rate. Plus, see our privacy notice. bbc.co.uk/5live.
Okay, straight into the calls. We're going to head to Dean, who is from Watford. He's got a very interesting idea, Robbie. Hi there, Dean.
Hi, good evening to you.
Hi, Dean.
How are we doing?
Go on, Dean. What's your interesting point?
Pay the penalties before you start the first playoff.
Pardon?
2:30, you take the penalties.
Hang on, start again. What did you say?
At 2:30, you take the penalties.
Right.
And then 3:00, you play the game.
Ooh. Right.
And then, if it's a draw, you then move to the replay.
Right.
And then, but depending on the first team who won the penalties, is the winner.
When's the winner? After the replay or after the first game?
No, the penalties at 2:30.
What?
So if you hang on, where's the replay come into it then?
Yeah, because you take the penalties at the beginning of the game, which is let's say 5-3.
Yeah.
Yeah. But if it's a 0-0, yeah, you still go to Liverpool, Manchester, but.
So you go back. So I've got you. So you play the game 0-0. You take the penalties at 2:30. And then if it's a draw in the replay, you go back to 2:30 from like the week before, and whoever won that penalty shootout goes through.
Correct.
Wow, that's bizarre.
Why?
Unique. Dean, I've got to say, I love the way you're thinking, but I've got to say, I've never heard such nonsense in my life.
Well, you don't like a bit of pre-game penalty?
Hang on.
Yeah, pre-game penalty.
There you go. That's okay. Got a ring to it, that.
Hang on. The result at the beginning.
So you know the result before you've done it then?
No, it's 3-2, 4-1. Yeah, exactly. But if you go for a replay, you will then go to the replay, but the big team will come out and say, shit, we've got to play.
You can't swear. Sorry about the language. But Dean, you're going to take away... I've been involved in penalty shootouts. Yeah. So basically, in a penalty shootout, and I'm sure we've all watched, all the listeners have watched penalty shootout, the emotion of scoring a winning penalty is incredible. I've done it against David Seaman in a FA Cup replay. So basically, can you imagine at 2:30, ground half empty, you score the winning penalty? Where's the emotion? You've scored, because you're all thinking, I've scored the winning penalty at 2:30. Before the replay.
if it happens.
A week later, it might come.
Well, there we go.
There we go.
Thank you, Dean. I know we know that you didn't mean it, but apologies for any bad language that you heard there from Dean.
I love that, didn't you? I love his thought process, but imagine scoring the winning penalty at 2:30 a week before the game.
You never know. Innovative. If anyone's got any innovative ideas,
I've just scored a winning penalty, and I've just got in the dressing room to warm up before the game.
Job done. Right.
I love this show. I really do. It's brilliant.
Okay.
Dean is unique thinking. Yeah. I love it. At least Dean's coming up with a thought process to try and improve the FA Cup. Love it.
I like it. Anyone else? Get in touch. 08085 909 693. Let us know if you've got any ideas. Penalties before, after, during, mid. Who knows? I know what, Robbie. Let's throw another two footballs in.
My Twitter's gone mad. My Twitter's gone mad.
He's gone. He's lost it. Okay.
I'm just picturing myself in a game. Get the ground to go warm up at 2:15 for penalty shootout. Nobody be in the ground. Imagine, what would you do if you scored at 2:30 the winning penalty? What would you do?
You'd love it. At least you get to celebrate if you scored a goal.
You had to go back to the changing room and warm up again.
Right. Well, you compose yourself. Let's hear from Giles, who is a Manchester City fan. Hi there, Giles.